Let's go and explore the National Waterfront Museum in Swansea. Look at this old beauty. This is the Gilburn Invader Mark III. Some old motorbikes here.
The cat about is easy to maneuver, comfortable, and the broad tires make it practically skid-proof. And the designer has done such a good job that even our weather doesn't bother the rider. True, blimey, what next? The idea of a miniature motorbike isn't new. There were many kinds of motor scooter after the First Great War, but this is the first to be mass-produced. The gadabout is just the thing for built-up areas and is as fast as any form of transport, especially since it's all yours. Maximum speed is 40 miles an hour, but it'll cruise at 30 for just as long as the petrol lasts. The tank holds 2 gallons, and that's enough juice for 200 miles.
It's an old solar car.
But he won't be late. He'll be lucky enough to get hold of one of the new Swallow
Gallon. We probably wouldn't fit in that. Doesn't look all that comfortable anyway.
Each day they set out not knowing exactly how far they'd go. It depended very much on the conditions. Through the north of Italy, they had to cross the Apennines, and that slowed them down a lot, especially as they hit a lot of bad weather. Though the height gave them a good run back down to the coast to meet the Mediterranean again. They drove along the south coast of France, having done a quick circuit around Monte Carlo on the way, and across the flatlands and down into northern Spain. I wonder what Salvador Dali would have made of that strange journey. By the time they got to Madrid, they had quite a following in the media.
More on the transport side of things, yeah? Look at this old buggy. Wow. In there as well. just now look inside it. Looking contraption, some form of tricycle. There's quite a few Sinclair C5s here as well. Ships can't then.
International airports, traditional seaside towns have found themselves losing out to cheap holidays abroad. In the last 20 years, the communications networking of Wales has expanded enormously. Buried alongside roads and railways are fibre optic cables that connect the world's computers. These invisible networks will shape the future in ways we cannot imagine.
History on coal in here, look. Well, look at these old tugs, yeah. I think the second one is a light ship. Seeing them. The rest of Swansea Marina. Not the best of days to go out for men, but there you go. And this is some of the trams that are there. Unfortunately, this place isn't open today. Swansea Museum Tramway Centre. Well, lucky as moth. Multicolored one. So look at all these model boats. The copper from the copper works. And that's one of the first GoPros that most YouTubers used back in the day. What else have we got? Yeah. Wow, the white fan then, fleet. What do we have for a Cumnock? From the Mambles and Porthcawl. That's a big model. Smaller models, yeah. Haven't quite got the detail of the big stuff. But... on Swansea Docks. The engineer inside of Swansea. there it is, National Waterfront Museum in Swansea. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell and all that, and we'll see you all in the next one.